Anyone, please, someone help me.
Hello, and welcome back to the kid in the back. I know y'all thought I forgot about this game. I promise y'all I didn't whatsoever. I just took on some other projects, that's all. If you are new here, hi, I'm Voyia. I play a variety of games. If you want me to play something, please do not hesitate to ask me to play something. Now, we're going to just go ahead and jump into it. This was my last loading, I guess. I'm going to hope I'm in the right area. This should be like the end of day one, I guess. You plop yourself onto the soft cushions of your bed, getting into the comfortable position and slowly dozing off as you close your eyes, embracing sleep as the night goes. Okay. Hello? And this maiden, she lived with no other thought than to love and be loved by me. Oh boy. This is slowly trickling into creep vibes. The one who loves. I was a child as she was a child. In the kingdom by the sea. Okay. Day two. Now, you guys know that this game had updated and day two came out. I'm going to try to play all of day two, okay? So, before y'all even ask, yes, I'm going to try to... This is going to be a long, chunky, big one, okay? So, don't even be like, oh, great, here's another one. The sun setting by the horizon colors the grassy fields into a deep golden orange as the wind made some strands of hair brush across your face. Your ever-beloved home... The tall grass, the fresh air, the various farm animals that you and your family raised since you were but a mere child. You can't even imagine what was happening before you right now as a group of people came while they talked with your father. Hopefully it's not a group of people with pitchforks. Your only family member left. You see the distress in your father's eyes as he tries his best to negotiate with the people before him. The desperation in his face, the sweat running down his neck as he moves around his hands, gesturing this and that.
Please, just give me more time. I promise I can pay up. This is all we have left. I don't know where else to go if we lose the farmland.
You were given enough chances already, Mr. Swallows. Okay, so my dad has my last name. Oh, Jesus. If you don't pay up your debt, we will take your land. Oh, no. So, in a sense, our family, Jesus, that's loud. I hope it's not loud for you guys. I always gotta check the sound because sometimes it be... fine, sometimes it's not, but it seems okay. I guess it seems okay. I'll even go and just kind of go to preference and just turn down this volume just a little bit, that way it's not too loud. Hopefully it's not. The loud ringing of the school bell rang across the hallways, making you jerk out of your thoughts. Students came out through the classroom doors. You feel someone shaking you awake. You set up and met face to face with Crow. Okay, so he came to wake us up. I appreciate it. I do think he's adorable. I really do think he's very, very cute. It's just dark and mysterious. So like, you know, elegant, classy, tall and handsome, or dark and mysterious. Y'all know I'm gonna go for dark and mysterious. All of us will.
Well, good morning, Sleeping Beauty. You let out a yawn. You rub your eyes as you look around. Your fellow classmates are now gone from their seats as it is now lunchtime.
What did I miss?
Nothing important, though if you are having doubts, I can lend you my notes afterwards.
Thanks, Crow. You're a lifesaver.
Anything for you, Voyia.
So I think Crow might have a little crush on me too. I hope so. I mean, because... it did mention that there are two love interests, and I'm going to assume it's somebody in my group. And since I don't remember if my character had a crush
on Crow, but if she does have a crush on Crow, then, you know, there's Crow, and then she has, God, what was the boy with the dark hair name? Oh, man, it sucks that I forgot his name. Oh, they're gonna tell it to me, but yeah, him too. Mr. Dark and Mysterious that we worked with. You recall the little dream you had. You quickly shake it off as you let out a stretch, popping a few joints before you got up and went out of the classroom with Crow in tow. You met up with a group of your friends, seeing Darrow with Gio and Crow waiting by the lockers, Brittany coming along behind them, and Jess. So we're all in the group chat, so we all are, I guess, friends. I hope you're not in a group chat with a bunch of people that don't like you. You wave at them. Oh, look at them. Oh, my goodness. I did want to spend time with them, and I am going to go back and get the other endings. I just want to play through the whole entire game, and then we'll dive deeper into getting other endings and stuff instead of just getting a whole bunch of, I don't know, just it'll be confusing if I got multiple endings and the game isn't finished yet. So I'm going to wait till the game is finished, and then I'm going to dive deeper and get more endings. But they're all cute. Oh, my God. Good noon to you all. I'm assuming Darrow is the one with the green sweater on because he is, the letters were green.
Regards, Darrow. How was class? Boring and boring. So glad to be out of there. One more useless minor and I'll be out of here.
Oh, great. It's one of those, like, school is so boring. School's lame. Gio just shrugged, his hands in his hoodie pocket while the other on this phone. Okay, so Gio must be short hair. And he's cute too. I think I gave this person a very nasally voice, like this. I think I'm going to change it up because looking at how they're standing, their whole demeanor and stuff, I think they might be just like a little shy, little timid, little mousy person.
We got to at least do something in our major today, though. Which I'm glad about. More papers, but it was at least something.
Enough about papers. So about the Halloween party, any ideas for a costume yet?
No one's thinking about costumes. I'm sure most of these children are not gonna, not children. I think this is college. I think most of them are not even thinking about that. They're like, I'm not even gonna dress up. I'm just gonna go and look at all the cute girls that dress up.
As they talk with each other, at the corner of your eye, you noticed a familiar figure.
Yeah, him. I couldn't remember his name. Soul. Goodness. No, his name is something that means soul, I think. I don't know. I forgot the whole meaning and what his full name is. But Soul is, and ooh, what was your name?
It was Soul. He came out of the classroom and another person came afterwards behind him, seemingly bored of his mind.
Ditch my friends or join Soul? I don't want to call Soul over because introducing new people, especially to some kids that assuming that they're popular kids, and then introducing the quiet child to the popular kids, there's going to be some people like, ew, like, go away, he's nasty, he's gross and stuff, especially pink girl. Stay with the group is kind of mean because I'm sure, like, we don't want to ignore Soul. Plus, dark and mysterious. We like that. Let's join Soul.
Oh, Crow, is it okay if I leave? I have somewhere else to be at. Is that so?
There was a slight disappointment in his voice, but he lets you continue on.
Yeah, sorry, I can't hang out.
Nonsense. I'll see you after lunch instead, then, Voyia. If ever you're interested, of course.
Of course.
Never gonna be interested to hang out with the jock, the preppy pretty girl, the timid child, and the whatever, everything suck, everything's boring, the emo kid and the classy kid. Sorry, that's just not my style. I'm more of a let's hang out in the back of the school and not be noticed by any kids whatsoever type of person.
You give Crow one last smile before going over to where Soul is. You walk towards the two individuals. They seem to be in a deep conversation. However, Soul noticed your presence and stopped talking, his attention now on you. His companion noticed the change in Sol's demeanor and followed his gaze as it landed on you. The shorter male greeted you with a smile.
Hi there. I remember the voice I gave him. I think it was also kind of like nasally like this.
Hey there. You're friends with Sunny?
Sunny?
Sunny.
And he gave Sol a pat on the back with a smile on his face. Sol was unamused as he tried his best to hide his red face behind his hands.
You know, because he's such a sunshine, he's Sunny.
Aw, that's a cute name.
You giggle, looking over Sol, his bright red face covered by his hands while looking away.
Like a nickname?
Yes. Sunny loves the nickname I give him, right, Sunny?
Sol didn't say anything. He just looked away and refused to meet your gaze.
How adorable. That is very adorable.
Hugo, okay, so his name is Hugo, was a bit silent. He seemed to be analyzing your face. His head tilted slightly to the side before a smile appeared on his face.
You sure have taste, Sunny. She is very pretty, like you said.
You were bragging about me? Oh my goodness, Sol, that's cute.
Sol just gave him a dark look, telling him not to even try to go there. A blush escapes his cheeks at the gesture.
Anyway, nice to meet you. My name is Hugo. I'm Sol's friend.
Voyia, a pleasure to meet you. Now, we... Oh, you know what? This is why we don't know who he is. We went through another playthrough, a second playthrough, and this is why I said it's confusing, and that's why I'm going to stick to one playthrough until we finish it, and then I'm going to go back through and get other endings. But we went through a second playthrough to try to get a second ending, which we did. We got a second ending, but it was just the same in a sense. So we met him on the roof at one point, and... Yeah, we talked to him. He told us his name. He asked us to partner up with Sol and stuff. But in this playthrough, I don't think we know each other. Because I was just about to say, didn't we introduce ourselves to him at one point? But we didn't. We introduced ourselves in another one. He shakes your hand with a smile on his face. Okay. It was taking a while to load in Sol there.
So anyway... What are you up to, Voyia?
Oh, I just saw you both and I wanted to greet you.
Anyway, we're planning to go to the rooftop today and eat lunch there. The weather is doing better, unlike yesterday. You want to tag along with us, Voyia?
You guys aren't a fan of the cafeteria? Like, that's where usually people eat their food. Upon mentioning the cafeteria, Sol shivered as Hugo only gave a small chuckle.
Sunny isn't a huge fan of the noise there.
I heard there's a food fight that happened yesterday.
Right? Though, not gonna lie, a food fight sounds fun.
He looks like the person that would start the food fight.
What are you, high school?
At least I have fun a little bit, Sunny. Anyways, enough talking. Let's get going, shall we?
Sure. Yeah, let's head to the roof, I guess. Hugo walked to his usual spot and got himself seated on a bench that you somehow never saw before. Sol followed, a large wrapped box in his hands that caught your interest. Sit beside Sol, sit between them, sit beside Hugo. I think this is where the love interest thing comes in. See, I thought it was Crow and Sol. It's not Crow and Sol. I'm not gonna say it's not Crow, okay? But I thought it was Crow and Sol. It seems like it's going to, if I take certain routes, it would lead me towards Sol and Hugo being the love interest. Because I think it's only two love interests. So I think I'm going to sit beside Sol, just in case that's the love interest, I guess. Sol noticed you from the corner of his eye. The edge of his lips going upward. You pointed to the box nestled in Sol's hand.
Is that your lunch, Soul?
You can say that.
As Soul unwraps the cloth, it shows you three bento boxes. He takes out the first bento box on top before giving the other one to Hugo. Hugo happily accepted the box, uttering a small thank you to Soul before taking out his chopsticks. Hugo opened the container and lets out an aw sound, his eyes sparkling. Drool slowly drops down the corner of his lips. Ew! That bento box must look delicious.
You actually listened, and did you cut these tiny sausages into octopuses?
Keep your voice down. It's ringing in my ears.
Wait, I need to take a picture of it.
Hugo gently placed the bento on his lap before rummaging through his phone. He flipped it horizontally and opened his phone's camera. A small click of the camera sound was heard before he placed it down. Hugo took the container back into his hands, but not before turning to you and showing you what he keeps gushing about.
Oh my! Isn't it adorable, Voyia?
There, you see our various ranges of food with rice shaped to match a moth. That is so cute! Oh my goodness! I don't know what the moth and the octopus have to do with each other, plus the stars I see. I think that might be broccoli in the top, but I'm not for sure, like broccoli and cheese. And I want to say those are mushrooms, but, you know, whatever. There you see a various ranges of food with rice shaped to match a moth. Seaweed to design the face along with using the cabbage leaves to form its wings. That's so adorable. Right below the moth are many sausages shaped like octopus. Wonderfully cut carrots were made to look like stars and squeezed beside the stuffed shiitake mushrooms. The egg roll sushi and broccoli are with melted cheese, as a dip look delicious. Oh, that's so cute.
I almost feel too bad to eat it.
Someone tell me what that says. Without wasting another second, Hugo started digging in.
Did you make this by yourself, Soul?
You can say that.
Soul answered, opening his own container. Within it was just a regular ham and cheese sandwich.
So why did he make himself such a simple thing, but then like went all extravagant and fancy with Hugo's box?
Now I think Soul might have a crush on Hugo and not me.
He took out one piece, but before he could take a bite, he turned to you.
Have you eaten, Voyia?
Well, we were asleep in class, so I'm gonna assume no, we haven't. Soul's eyes went wide and Hugo gave you a look. Before you knew it, Soul took out another box, the last bento box, before giving it to you.
You can have this. It's an extra.
Oh, he made an extra. Why do you have an extra?
I didn't like how this looked, but I figured I can let Hugo finish it. It's a waste of ingredients.
You don't have to, Soul, really.
No, I insist.
Oh, for frick's sake, just eat the same box.
Hugo's just done with us. Hugo clearly had enough of our back and forth banter, suggested before continuing on his box. So hesitated at first. He eventually took out a spoon and a fork and handed out one to you. Take a bite or tease him.
Let's tease him.
Of course we're gonna tease him. Watch this get me murdered. You decline his offer of the utensils, making him raise a brow in confusion.
You don't want a spoon? Or do you prefer chopsticks?
Nothing of the sort.
Then what is it?
I want you to feed me.
Look how much he blushed. That nearly took Soul out. Hugo gave you a side eye, a judgmental look on his face as he stopped eating. He scooted a bit away from you too. He's like, ew, I don't want to catch the cootie ick stuff that you're trying to give out, Voyia. He scooted a bit away from the two of you before returning to his meal. Soul, however, was nervous for a bit.
his eyes still transfixed on yours, still couldn't believe what he had just heard.
Are you just going to keep staring at her or what?
Shut up. I'll feed her. I'm a little animal to him. So gripped the spoon in his hand, taking a few pieces from the bento box before turning to you. His eyes averted away from you, a wild blush on his face as he raised the spoon to your face. His hands were shaking a bit, seemingly nervous. You took a bite and chewed. You felt the flavors mixing well. It was delicious and fresh. It's amazing. So this is really good. Hugo nodded along with you, food stuffed in one cheek like a hamster.
I know, right? You'd honestly be surprised.
So, making lunch for Hugo. You'd make a great house husband. Yeah, I'm gonna always choose the flirty stuff in these, okay? Eventually, I'm gonna go back and replay it, so I probably won't choose flirty stuff. But still, I'm just gonna choose the flirty stuff, okay? Sol's eyes widen at your declaration.
You really think so?
I really do think so. Oh, he's so flattered. I didn't even get to read it. I hate when it does that. Do you want to marry me? I think that's what that said. Hold on, one more time. Do you want to get married to me? That's what it said.
Sol is definitely house husband material, Voyia. He can cook, he can clean, he can do anything.
I'd rather not be your own personal butler.
That was a compliment.
The two banter, but you couldn't help looking at Sol. His eyes have a hint of sparkle in it. It seemed brighter. Forgive me, my voice is going away, you guys, so bear with me. Hugo eventually finished his own box, tucking away the box and wrapping it back up. Hugo stood up from the bench, stretching his limbs, walked a few steps ahead, and looked back at the both of you. Is this what you guys do every day? You question, making Hugo turn to you. Or at least when you both get together?
What do you mean? You mean so giving me lunch?
He just keeps forgetting to bring his own. Hugo pouts.
And you never finish yours, so I do the honors of ever finishing good food. Thank you very much.
Those bento box art, what inspired them, if you don't mind me asking?
Oh, you don't know.
Shut up, Go-Go.
Go-Go? Oh, now we're using the nicknames now, Sonny. How sweet of you. You see here, Voyia, my old pal here just makes food art. Like a typical artist that he is.
So he does know how to draw. Again, I went back and got two different endings. So I don't know which ending this is, but I'm assuming this is one where we didn't meet Hugo on top of the roof.
But he never bothers to finish it, much less eat it. And he really loves cute things like...
Hugo turns back to Sol. Sol just stared back at him, his arms crossed.
What was the name of your plushy horse, Sonny?
Like hell I am answering that.
Boo.
He owns a plush horse? So? Owns plushies? By now, So's face is beet red as he ties the bento boxes back up. He stood up from his seat before going over to where Hugo was. You stood up as well and followed along the duel.
That's so cute. You just keep surprising me more and more, so.
He said nothing as he fixed his choker, the red going up to his ears at your compliment. That's so cute.
Looks can be deceiving.
This begs you to wonder, why do people never bother to notice him? Why don't people want to get to know him? Maybe they just never gave him a chance because of how he looks, not to mention his intimidating height. But in the end, he's just a gentle giant.
Oh, and he's just misunderstood.
Oh, please don't be a killer. Please don't be a killer because I am starting to love you. So don't be a killer, okay? By then, Hugo stopped talking, the wind picking up a bit as we went by the railings. He
He leaned in and placed his elbows on the cold iron surface as he looked down. Curious, you approached him and looked down to where his attention was. And there you see two groups of unfamiliar people. They look so fancy. They look rich. Dangerous. It doesn't help that the adult with them, you're guessing a teacher, has an eye patch on his right eye. Jesus, okay.
High class mugs.
Sol lets out a disgusted look at the group of well-dressed students. He didn't spare them a second glance and went back to the bench. Oh no, he must have some grudge against them. High class?
Ah. You don't know about the hierarchy, Voyia.
No, not that I'm aware of. This is the first time I've ever heard of it. How come I never heard or seen one of them throughout my school years here? Hugo just made a low chuckle, his gaze still transfixed on the group below him. His eyes narrowed. Just like Sol, he clearly doesn't like them either.
I don't blame you. No one likes talking about them anyway.
Oh, look at this. He looks so cute right there. High class.
About the hierarchy. Let's talk about that. How come I never heard of the hierarchy before?
It's like a hidden thing, but that's what we call it. This school? No. This entire city. It's like a fighting pit. Whoever is the most powerful has a better chance of living a good life here. People come to this school to gain a second chance in life. But to achieve that, you have to make yourself well known, making them think you're worth their time. If not, you're on your own.
Okay. High class? Question mark. He glares at the group below.
This school building isn't actually the real thing.
Wait, what? But the school map clearly says that the address is...
That's where they actually fool you. You may think you got it right, but we are sorted based on our background. The real school building, way further than where we are. And their campus is 10 times bigger and better. They get proper classes, have better equipment. Everything is just better. Here, we only get the short end of the stick. The afterthought, if you will.
If I have to guess, the well-off are in the main building?
That's right. Son of a duke. Daughters of a businessman. Heck, as long as you're rich, you're in. Your chances for having better education rest there. If you are part of the high class, you'll have a better chance of having a successful and stable life.
But don't we have students here who are, like, super rich? You remember Jess being one. She is the daughter of a businessman, but how come she's not part of the higher class? That is very interesting because I would assume that, like, Crow, Brittany, and Daryl, and all of them and stuff would be, like high class, in a sense. Rich kids. That's what my first thought was. Oops, I skipped a part. Sorry, gotta go back. But yeah, it's weird that they're not considered high class if they're rich.
There are some who end up shifted down and moved to our building. Either they failed a class or got a violation. They didn't want that type of stain on their reputation, so they sent them here. Of course, some didn't appreciate that. They see us as someone lower than them, hence.
Hugo looks at Sol. The said man too busy sketching in his sketch pad to notice.
Oh. They have to fight the weak to feel something, huh?
They sound like nothing but bullies. How come someone didn't step up to complain? Hugo, however, just laughed at you as if you told him a very funny joke before shaking his head.
If only it was that easy.
His laugh eventually died down as he scratched his head.
Actually, Voyia, in this city... No one really gives a shite. Money is the only thing revolving around this city. You've got no cash, you're done for. Which is why people like us, he looks at you, are desperate to get into the higher class. If you so dare complain. He paused, as if contemplating the words he's about to say. Judging from his entire demeanor, it's not good. Instead, he sent you a look. His once soft blue eyes are now sharp, like icicles piercing down on you. You're better off dead. Oh, wow.
So, basically, it's just the battle of the rich and the poor. If you're not poor, but, you know, the lower class or whatever, which is kind of what the world is like right now, you know. The rich eat the poor, blah, 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 all that stuff, which is crazy. It's so insane and scary to think about.
Hugo glanced one last time before the group of high-class students are now gone, before averting his gaze on somewhere else. He lets out a sigh. But that's the sad reality here. The attention is good, great even. Your chances to get a stable life and even have a knock at stardom is high once you're part of the high class, much less graduate here.
Okay, I think guess that's all we needed to know.
The city is corrupted, he muttered under his breath. Which makes me question, Voyia, how are you able to get in the city? No, the better question is, why did you enroll in this school, if you don't mind me asking, that is? You're clearly not from here.
And that he was right. Your eyes widen at the words that the well-dressed man said.
No! I refuse! Voyia, give me a chance to read it, Jesus.
Voyia, I thought I said to stay inside.
Thank you for giving me a chance to read it, Jesus.
You're not taking this farm, my home. You cut your father's words, marching towards the tall man with loud and heavy footsteps.
The tall man, however, raised a brow to you, raising his hand to halt his man. Oh yeah, they was like, they was about to get you, girl. But Voyia's gonna stand up for her family.
His deep magenta eyes then turned to look straight into your eyes. It sent chills down your spine. Well then, little Uwu, how about this? If you manage to pay off your debt within the next 5 years, I'll let you off the hook and let you keep your land. 5 years? You can handle that.
Yeah, just get a nice, decent job. Get a little side hustle. Save up some money. How much is the debt? Because if you say like $1 million, you might not be paying that off anytime soon. But like if it's like $100,000 or something, I feel like you could, with 5 years, you could make that if you try like really, really hard.
Maybe working 3 jobs will do it for you. He tutted, waving a finger in front of your face. He looks down at you, reminding you of your place. A mischievous smile appears on his handsome features.
Of course, my character would notice that the person that's trying to take our family's land is handsome. Oh, Voyia swallows. Shame on you.
But I have some conditions you have to meet. You were silent. Your heart started pounding in your chest as you kept eye contact with this sharp magenta orbs. I want you to stay in the city.
The city? But we can't even afford to take her to college. What more, the city?
Your father interrupted. The man's eyes moved sideways to meet his figure still fixed on you. No need to worry. She'll be under my jurisdiction, of course. I'll provide for her education and place to stay.
The tall man lets out a laugh, his head thrown a bit back as if he had just heard a very funny joke.
See, I'm not that cruel.
His eyes return to you.
However, in return, I want you to pay off your debt. I don't care what methods.
You know, if I had this offer to me years ago when I was like 21, 23. I would have took it at 23. I would have took this. Now that I'm 30, nah. I'd have been like, absolutely not. I don't even know what I would go back to school for. I hated school anyway. I hated college, school, all of it. Elementary, everything. I hated waking up in the morning. No, thank you.
A dark smile appeared on his face. It sent shivers down your spine. Legal or illegal? As long as you reach the amount. If not, well. You can say goodbye to your little farmland. He says that, but there was a gleam in his eye that is telling you that that is not all. But he did not elaborate any further. You bit your lip. You turned to look at your father. His eyes were clearly telling you to decline. There was something about this man that screamed dangerous. But you were too desperate to lose your home, your only home. So, what do you say, Voyia? The tall man gazed still fixed on you, waiting for your answer. Do you accept? You recall the aftermath of your dream this morning, a soured look on your face as you bit your lip. Hugo takes notice of it. He paused for a bit, trying to read your gloomy expression.
Let me guess. It's something you can't avoid.
I honestly don't know. My father never really disclosed as to why we were in debt. But I was so desperate to not lose my only home. I need to make it up to the higher class no matter what. Three jobs isn't cutting off the way I want it to be. I'm running out of time. This is my last year in this cursed university, and I'm barely making any progress.
Hugo's eyes are still on you. You realize you haven't answered his question yet.
My family owns a business. You finally speak, making Hugo perk up his eyebrows in curiosity.
Okay, well, maybe we can change the subject a little bit.
What sort of business, if you don't mind me asking? Oh, well, we own a few farms. Sounds nice. I'd love to be out of the city once in a while.
You gave him a small smile.
Yeah, some might say it's boring, but it's not. You get to pet horses and cows.
Fun fact, I've always wanted to ride a horse, but I always switch this up because I can't really fully remember if it was a cow or a horse, but I think it was a cow. Or whatever. Anyways, but long time ago, I had really long hair. Really, really long hair. Down my back long hair. And as a kid, I went to the Del Mar Fair in California. Some of y'all may know that if you're from Cali. Some of y'all may not. But I went there and the cow or the horse, I really want to say it was a cow more than a horse, chewed off my freaking braid. No, it was a horse. I remember because we were getting to ride the horse. The freaking horse chewed off my braid. And I've been terrified of horses ever since.
Then you should really invite Sol over then, if ever. That guy loves horses. But that means you're a long way from home. Don't you miss it?
It sounds like Voyia would actually miss it, so a little bit. Yeah.
That's all right. It's normal to feel a little homesick.
I heard great things about this city, about the school.
Hugo remained quiet, listening to you as you went on.
If I can manage to come up on top and maybe a part of the higher class, like you said, then I can maybe save my family's farm.
Hugo's arms are now crossed. He didn't say anything as he looked at you.
He lets out a chuckle.
You remind me of her.
Like her?
I'm rambling. Don't mind me.
Having caught red-handed, he waved around his hands. His face is now as red as a cherry as it reached his ears.
Just then, you felt a presence behind you. Turn around, you're met with Sol. His glare is stinging and directed at Hugo.
The shorter male, however, didn't mind. Probably used to it.
It's almost time we should head back.
All right, all right.
With nothing else to do, the three of you left the rooftop. Okay, well, at least we got to bond a little bit, and I got to get to know Hugo a little more. Sad that we didn't get to really fully know Sol, but maybe we'll get some more time with him in this day. I think only day two has been released, so. As you were walking down the stairs, however, you felt your foot slip off. Oh no, you missed a step.
Voyia.
Thankfully, Sol grabbed your waist before you could fall off the stairs as he steadied you.
Well, you're all right there, Voyia?
Yeah, thank you, Sol.
Be careful next time.
Sheesh, this school and its bad architecture. Also, one of the few flaws here. The squares are all wonky.
It's also why it's forbidden to go up here.
We're troublemakers, though.
Oh boy, I found myself a couple of cute troublemakers. How lovely.
Hugo chuckled as he went down the stairs, watching his step as he did so.
Sol's arm is still secured around your waist. It seems he is not letting go until you are all on stable ground.
Well, at least he's protecting me. I'm very happy about that. Although, I feel like if kids start seeing that, they're going to start coming up with their own narrative about us, which is none too good whatsoever.
The sound of the bell ringing throughout the hallway echoes through, signaling the start of next classes for some. Hugo groans.
Aww, I don't want to go to class. I hate my history teacher as much as my archery coach.
Why don't you just skip then?
Hugo's eyes popped open. It became bright like a light bulb just popped out of the top of his head.
Sol knows exactly what that look means. Oh boy, we're gonna skip. He's gonna skip at least.
I'm going to skip class. How about it? Frick this school. If they're going to treat us badly, then let's be the bad guys.
Oh, Hugo. We just told you how we're trying to save our farmland and get to the high class, and your next thing was like,
I understand you're going through something, you're trying to make it. Let's skip.
Yeah, thanks, Hugo.
Hugo said with a mischievous look on his face. Sol just sighs. He then turns to look at you, seemingly waiting for your response. The thought of skipping is quite a gamble. Your next class is with Crowell in art history. But then again, your teacher will probably only do some boring but introductions. Missing one wouldn't hurt, would it?
Yeah, as long as we just skip one, maybe. Maybe not skip a bunch of them, but let's just skip one.
Hugo lets out a small cheer and gives you a thumbs up. Sol gives you a cheeky smile of his own.
But how are we going to do that, though? Obviously, we can't go through the entrance since it is closed and guarded.
I know a way. Without wasting any more time, Sol leads the way, going through the back side of the school near the gardens.
Okay.
The edges, of course, were barricaded by a tall iron fence. Sol finds a bush and pushes it to the side, revealing a gaping hole.
Well, that's quite convenient. Did you make that hole, Sol?
He did.
I did.
Hugo went ahead first through the hole, so wait for you first before following right after. The three of you went past a few bushes and shrubs, the leaves falling as you passed by them, the red and orange leaves scattered around, and some making its way to your uniform before you all eventually made it out and met with the pavement.
So,
where do we go? Hugo thought for a moment, looking around, but pulling out his phone. Suddenly, he lets out a gasp, scrolling through his phone faster before gripping on Sol's shoulder, earning him a hiss from the taller male.
Sherlock Holmes is out.
My ears.
Oh, yeah, it's that detective movie I keep seeing on television. I thought that won't come out till next week. Did I set the date wrong?
With that, Hugo started sprinting, leaving you and Sol behind.
For the love of...
I'm taking it that Sol doesn't like movies.
Sol So placed a hand on his hip before walking to where Hugo ran off to as you followed. Hugo kept tapping away on his phone. His shoulders went slumped. Guess he did get the date wrong. Shoving his phone back in his pocket, he turned to you and saw. He clasped his hands together and pulled the biggest puppy eyes you've ever seen.
We have got to watch it. Can we, Voyia? Can we, Sunny?
Oh, look at his little sad face. Hugo begged. You can go ahead and watch the movie. I'm going to roam the arcade while you're at it. Hugo pouted. His eyes went half-lidded, and sparkles in his eyes were gone.
But it's more fun when you're around. I know you like those crime videos you watch from time to time, so please.
So, however, based off his expression, isn't in the mood. Hugo gives up and turns to you.
How about you, Voyia? Would you like to watch the movie with me? The ticket and food are on me, of course.
No, but we could go to the arcade with Soul. I feel so bad, and I'm probably going to come back through and do this anyway, so it doesn't really matter. But since I'm like in the dark and mysterious, I'm going to stick with the dark and mysterious. I'm sorry. If he cries, I will literally rewind this back and go to the movies with him.
Hugo shrugs.
All right. Go on to your little impromptu date anyways. Besides, I don't want a third wheel either way.
Date? Yeah, we didn't say it was a date. I just want to get to know Soul a little bit. That's all. Before we date.
You're the one who decided we should skip class and do whatever we want.
Yeah, and I want to watch a movie. Well, don't let me stop you two.
Oh, Hugo, I'm sorry.
Hugo stuck his tongue out at Soul. The said male only rolled his eyes.
Well, I'll be heading in now. I'll just give you guys a call where to meet.
Sure. You and Hugo parted ways. He gave you both a wave before heading in different directions. Soul turned to you.
Should we get going, Voyia?
Of course.
The flashing neon lights of the arcade's exterior lights your way. The sound of each arcade machine reaches your ears.
I've never been here before. Is this place new?
Not really. It's just hidden within the city.
I see, I see. Do you get out a lot, Soul? You seem to know places.
I know places because I get my butt dragged by Hugo.
It seems like Hugo is the leader, kinda.
Is that so?
You laugh. Soul just shrugged as he shook your head. He takes out a few coins from his pocket before handing it to you. They were tokens.
So, which one are you going for first?
Wow, you came in prepared.
As always. Come on.
Soul holds out his hand and you accept it. He held it tight with a light squeeze as you and him roam around the arcade. That's so sweet. You and Soul went and played multiple arcade games. Some you win and some he does. But you often get the feeling that he's letting you win for the sake of you winning.
Come on, Soul. That's like the fifth time I won. Ain't no way you're this bad.
Maybe you're just that good, Voyia.
You flatter me. Just as when you're about to insert another coin, however, you realize you've ran out of tokens.
Soul takes notice of this, of course, and gives out some of his to you.
Aww, Soul, you're so adorable.
I'll go to the counter and grab a few more tokens. You don't mind staying here for a bit, right?
Oh, how much should I pay you for the tokens?
It's on me, don't worry about it.
And he's paying for it.
My heart wouldn't let him do that. I'd be like, no, I definitely insist. You're giving me tokens. I'm going to pay you back some way. And if he just super insists that I don't pay back, I'll just give him something and not tell him I'm paying him back. I'd be like, okay, well, I have a gift for you.
Wait here.
Giving you one last look, he hurriedly went to the counter. You looked around the area. The dinging sounds from various machines filled the arcade. From the corner of your eye, you spot a claw machine. Maybe playing a few games wouldn't hurt. Going to the claw machine, you check the contents inside. A cat plushie, a Shiba Inu plushie, and a horse plushie. They all look so cute. Which one should I try to win? Let me think. I think we should get the horse plushie. They said so like horses, and we can just get him. This will be our thank you to him for giving us the tokens. You remember how Soul likes horses? Maybe you can try to win one for him? These are his tokens, after all. You took out some of the tokens Soul gave to you and inserted one in the coin slot. The machine whirls to life as you take the joystick on your left hand while hovering the red button on your right. You are focused, eyeing the claw in its position, trying to align it with the horse plush. Okay, did we get it? The claw takes hold of the plush. Your eyes widen as you cross your fingers, hoping it catches it. But you are interrupted with a sudden smack on your butt. Who put the hand on my cheeks that isn't Soul or Songetsu or Leon S. Kennedy? You jerk and turn around. What the frick?
Well, well, well. What do we have here?
Oh, great. It's one of the handsy guys. Ew.
Makes my booty cheeks itch. You turn around and you're met with a tall figure, a cocky smirk on his face. He looks well off, like those typical spoiled rich kids you see in movies. His hair a bit tousled, with two men you assumed are his bodyguards beside him. He reeks of tobacco, making you gag. Oh God, nothing worse than a man that smokes. You say nothing and try to move away from his sight, but you were stopped by another tall figure. You were guessing he's with his butthole.
Now where do you think you're going there, sweetheart? You alone?
Yes, and I would pretty much prefer to be alone. The man, however, did not listen.
Why don't you come with me and I'll show you how these games are played? No.
Ew. He raised his hand to reach your shoulders. Before he could touch you, however, you kicked him in between his legs. That's what I'm talking about, Voyia. Kick him harder and kick him again. He doubled over and clenched his lower region, a groan escaping his lips. His goons were taken aback and rushed to help him.
Now's my chance. Don't let her get away.
Multiple heavy footsteps were coming after you as you ran. You turned every corner you can, trying to make them lose you. But three against one is not a good matchup.
Anyone, please, someone help me.
You plead, but multiple sound effects and music from each machine within the arcade drowns your pleas. You curse under your breath as you focus on running. All you can think about at that moment is to get out.
Oh man, oh, we're in a bad situation and Soul's gone, so he doesn't know. And Hugo's at the movies, so no one knows what's happening to us. Oh, I hope that Soul just saw something or anything.
You manage to get out of the arcade, but you still clearly hear the man and the goons on your tail. You look around and you found a few toilet stalls. You rushed towards it and got in a stall, hurriedly opening and locking it as soon as you got in.
That is such a bad idea. You should have ran to like security, ran out, anything, ran to the movies. I would have ran to the movies that he's watching Sherlock Holmes. So I'm just saying.
This place stinks, but you didn't give it another thought as the beating of your heart rings through your ears, tears welling up in the corner of your eyes. Poor Voyia. You hear footsteps.
Find her.
The man's voice echoed. You try to think of something. You thought of calling Soul. You quickly took out your phone. No signal.
Of course no signal in the freaking bathroom.
Are you for real right now? You can hear how aggressive they tore open each stall. They creep closer and closer to where you were.
Anyone, please. Here you are.
No, please.
You've been a very bad girl. Don't worry.
You can make it up to me by doing me a favor.
Frick you and your favors.
Tsk, tsk, tsk. I've been kind to you, but it seems that you want me to do it the hard way. He forcefully grabbed the edge of your uniform. Your eyes went wide as your fingers went cold. You quickly grab a hold of his wrist as you try to push him away. He's too strong.
Oh no. This is like giving me anxiety. I don't want nothing to happen to Voyia.
You forcefully lift up your uniform, revealing your stomach to him. You're going to give me a good time, little Uwu. Boys, hold her down.
No! Frick off! Let me go!
The tears that were hanging by finally fell down your cheek as you tried to stop him from going any further. The two large men with him held you down as you tried to struggle, but to no avail. Your vision is slowly being blinded by the hot tears that were filling up. This is so sad. I'm about to cry. I don't like stuff like this. This really bothers me because I have been in situations like this, and it like my hands are shaking right now. It's even harder for me to read it. It's like, oh no. It's no use. His grip is too strong and there is no one near to hear me. You close your eyes shut. Please just end quickly.
What? Hey! What?
Judging from the impact, the man's body was jerked off of you as he was thrown to the side. Soul is here! It has to be Soul or Crow. It has to be somebody that we know or Daryl now. Oh my goodness, I hope it's just anybody. You hear flesh hitting flesh. And another one. Jesus. Oh my god.
Oh, that's enough, Soul.
Not yet. Oh my god.
That's enough. You broke his nose already.
No.
Okay. Soul. That's enough. Voyia needs your help.
He is beating the... He's beating the absolute shite out of him. My god. They should have showed the aftermath. The creator should have put like a picture of him with like just beat to shreds. That would have made my day. That would have been the thumbnail. Like, don't mess with Voyia. At the mention of your name, the familiar reddish eyes went wide open before turning to you. Soul quickly went to your side, his eyes wide with shock before crouching down and giving you a hug, his shoulders shaking as he embraces you. You said nothing, however, too stunned to speak to what transpired before you. The man now laid still on the ground, a pool of blood seeping out of him, the rest of his goons passed out on a random corner.
Hugo and, oh my goodness, and Soul saved me, my heroes. I love them both.
You look up and were met with all too familiar eyes of Hugo, but they weren't the kind of ones you usually see on his face. Hugo's eyes twitch as he sighed, trying to hide his visible irritation, but failing. Oh, so he's mad at me? I hope he's not mad at me. He looks around at the mess Soul made before turning to check up on you. Oh, so he might be upset with the situation. He's telling Soul to stop, but Soul hasn't stopped yet and went crazy. Okay. He said nothing, hands in his pocket, while he looks down at you and Soul's embrace.
It's quite late. We should head home.
Hugo taps Soul's shoulders, making the tall male bury his face further in between your neck before eventually letting go.
Oh my goodness! Soul, oh, I'm okay.
His eyes were bloodshot, his face red from either anger or worry. You aren't sure, but one thing's for sure is that this man before you cried.
Oh no, don't. Y'all know how I feel about handsome men in visual novels crying. It
tears my spirit. Is there something about me like, I don't care if you're a murderer, I love you. He cried for you.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I shouldn't have left you.
Soul,
you for saving me. Just thank him.
Oh, no! No! No!
These cute guys are gonna get me, I promise.
He's so cute! And oh, look at him cry. No.
You reach out to cup his cheek. He flinches at the touch. Tears that he was trying to hold back is now flowing freely down his cheeks.
No. Oh my God. It's too much.
This is too much for me. This is almost as cute as a big-eyed, adorable, like, bunny rabbit. I would just freak. Or like a little cat with a little big poofy eyes. Oh no, I would just cry.
You eventually relaxed as he closed his eyes and leaned into your hand as he held it.
I don't know what I'll do if...
It's okay. It's all right.
Here. Beside you, Hugo extended his hand for you to take. You noticed on his other hand is the same horse plush you tried to win back at the crane game.
They even picked up my plushie.
You took Hugo's hand as he helped you get up. So stands as well, but backs away.
Why?
From you a few steps. Sorry, I was just confused by the backing away thing. Like, you think you're gonna hurt me or something?
We should head back home. It's quite late after all.
Both you and So didn't say anything, but nodded along. He gives both of you a smile before walking away. So kept a firm hold on your hand, seemingly afraid to let go. Hugo lets out a sigh.
I guess we can't get in the arcade anymore. Those guys might come back to teach us a lesson.
If they come back, I'll give them more than just a broken nose.
You're pretty scary right now, So.
Good. I like to keep it that way.
Hugo shakes his head. He rummages through his pockets before handing So something.
You didn't quite see what it was, but judging on the scowl on Sol's face, he doesn't like it.
I told you these don't work anymore.
It's because you aren't taking them, you fool. Now, take it tonight.
Oh, you must have gave him some type of medicine or something. Sol grumbles like a child who got scolded before taking whatever Hugo gave to him and tucked it in his pocket.
Anyway, your place is around the corner. You should head back as soon as possible. I'll be taking Voyia home.
So's eyes narrowed. From holding your hand to wrapping his arm around yours in a possessive hold as he leans closer while still glaring at Hugo.
No, I can walk her home.
Clearly, you're not in a good condition to fight again.
I can fight again.
Oh, I wonder did he get hurt and he's just not, he's trying to hide it. Oh, that makes me worry. And then I'll feel even more terrible.
There was something in Hugo's eyes that made your blood cold. The usual happy-go-lucky expression he had on his face was gone. Looking back at Sol, he seemed unfazed at it, as if challenging him.
Hugo's right, Sol. You look beaten up.
But Voyia...
At least she knows her limits.
Sol says nothing but clenches his fists. You noticed a few red marks on his knuckles. Your eyes furrowed.
I'm fine, Voyia.
Sol tries to reassure you. You shook your head no.
Well, for me, you aren't.
You look up and give him a reassuring smile.
I'll be fine, Sol. Besides, I have Hugo to keep me safe. You go home first and get some rest.
Looks like he gave in.
All right.
Oh, so, oh my goodness, I forget that sometimes it pauses on its own. So wait, before you go.
He pauses in his tracks. He raised his brows in curiosity. Holding the stuffed toy horse in your arm, you gently hand it over to him, catching him by surprise. So, however, shook his head no, and gave back the horse to you. His hands wrapped around your hands as you hold the toy horse.
You won that. Plus, I don't deserve it. Not after that.
So he's holding himself accountable for the fact that he left me by myself, but you can't control buttholes, okay? And you can't be around somebody 24/7. I mean, I gotta poop sometimes, so you can't be there. I'm just saying.
And this is just so sad.
But I want it for you. Consider this a reward for saving me.
Sol stares at you in disbelief, from your face to the stuffed horse in your hands. His hands were shaking as he takes the toy horse from your hands, brushing your fingers, making him shiver. I'll take care of it, Voyia, I swear to you.
Oh, he's already acting like a boyfriend. That's so cute.
He squeezed your hands, too hesitant to let go before his hold eventually slips as he lets go. With that, Sol takes his leave. He walks backwards, his eyes still on you, making sure that you're in his sight before properly walking front. Hugo sighs. You turn to face him.
Well, ain't he a charmer? Is it working?
You raise an eyebrow at the question. Working what?
Charming you, obviously. Don't worry, it is our secret between you and me.
Jesus, Hugo. As much as I want to gossip like two queens, I can't look at you like a queen then, especially if you're a love interest. He says with a finger on his lips and a wink. You blushed.
He's nice. I owe him my life after that.
And?
You chuckle, thinking about the long-haired male. He is handsome. I'll admit that.
Uh-huh.
What's with that smirk on your face?
Oh, nothing.
Before you could retaliate with a question, his gaze softened, taking you a bit aback as he looked down at the pavement below, kicking a pebble.
Have you ever liked someone, Voyia?
What's with this sudden question?
Just answer.
You pause as you thought for a second, and for the first person that appeared in your mind was... Well, it definitely wasn't Crow, but... I'm gonna say Sol.
You thought of Sol.
How he protected you. How he didn't hesitate to beat those guys down. The pure terror in his eyes. How he worried he was.
Oh, yeah.
That's all us girls want. It's for you to just care about us. So sweet.
You couldn't get it out of your head. He's been an amazing friend. Even if he did beat up those guys. Nonstop.
Is it a red flag? Maybe. Do you care? Maybe not. A smile made its way to your face, and it was enough a confirmation for Hugo. Eventually, you arrive at the door of your apartment. You thank Hugo for accompanying you. He gives you a smile, rubbing the back of his head.
I'll see you tomorrow, Voyia. Sorry the day didn't go well.
It's okay, Hugo, but we're going to have a proper plan next time.
Of course.
Hugo nodded. He turned his heels, his back facing you, ready to leave. But he remained still at his spot.
Uh-oh. Voyia?
Yes?
Be careful walking late at night, okay?
You pause, turning your head slightly to him.
There's been multiple cases of missing people lately. I suggest you go home with someone. Anyone.
Uh-oh. This is making me worry. Now, I don't know if he's warning me because, like, he actually cares, or he's warning me because he knows who the person is. Like, he doesn't know who the person is and he's just worried about me, or does he know who the person is and he's just telling me, like, yo, be careful because now he knows who you are. Like, is it Sol? Is it Crow? Like, those are the people I'm worried about. Is it Brittany? You know, the people that I've already met before.
Just don't go alone, all right?
I understand. Missing people? When did that happen? No, when did it start?
Oh, and one last thing, Voyia.
He turns his head around as he looks at your confused face. His eyes soft, but the light against them seem like he's giving you a warning.
Take care of Sol for me, okay?
Well, now he sounds like he's leaving. And with that, he left. I mean, like, leaving the game or something, or he's gonna die or something. Don't make it sound so bad. Now I'm scared for him.
You entered your apartment, the light dimmed as you groaned, searching for the light switch.
Much better.
You nod in approval, heading to your kitchen. You opened the fridge and started rummaging around for something to eat. You sigh as nothing's good besides the leftovers from yesterday's dinner. You shrug, decided to heat this one up after you set your things down. You don't really feel like cooking or ordering either. You sigh as you close the door to the fridge as you made your way to your room. You place your school bag near the desk as you take your seat, skimming through the notes you've taken for the day as you wrote down needed notes. You clicked your tongue as you tapped your blank notebook with the tip of your pen, going on with the silent staring contest with the blank paper before you. You let out a groan. Deciding to do work later, you closed your notebook and stood up. You turned to the window, noticed it being slightly ajar.
That's weird. I thought I closed this.
You went near it to close it shut, but you were met with a now broken lock.
Oh no, somebody broke in my house now?
You cursed. I thought I already replaced this 2 days ago. Maybe I shouldn't buy a lock online.
I would have immediately went to whatever store is open 24 hours. Like, I would have called Hugo or Seoul or something and be like, look, I gotta go to the store. My window's broken. I gotta get a lock. And we would have went and got a lock immediately.
You let out a groan as you left it alone and went out of the room into the living room. You lost your mind. I'd be in that room watching that window. Your TV blurred as you munched on some leftovers you got from the fridge. The movie currently playing as you kept your eyes on the protagonist. If you recall correctly, it's one of those films Jess keep talking about, starring her favorite lead actor. You kind of get what she was gushing about. The lead does look attractive. Blonde wavy hair with sharp eyes, with eyes as pink as fuchsia. Okay. I thought it was going to be something after a dot dot dot. That's why I waited. And you still can't remember the actor's name. You took out your phone as you start to search up the name of the actor when you suddenly change, and instead of the blonde actor on the screen, a report comes instead. Excuse me, I had to cough. With the banner below. Another missing person case? Is this what Hugo was talking about? A shiver went up your spine, remembering the broken lock on your window back in the bedroom. Nuh-uh. Not tonight, Voyia. No scary thoughts for tonight. Turning off the TV, you went to the kitchen to grab something to drink. Opening your fridge, feeling the cold air hitting your face as you rummage through. Taking out the pitcher of orange juice, you take a glass from the cupboard as you pour the juice to the last drop, taking a sip from it. You check the clock on the wall, 9:30 p.m. That late already, huh? You check the front door and the windows, seeing everything is locked before grabbing your glass and finishing the last drop of orange juice before heading back to your bedroom. Okay, nice and cozy bed, nice and cozy bedroom, lights off, air on. Whoever sleeps with the heat on, you're a monster, okay? And I'm gonna assume you're the devil if you do. No one sleeps with the heat on, right? You let me know in the comment section below, do you sleep with the air on or the heat on? I had somebody tell me to sleep with the heat on. I immediately blocked them on every social media and the future social medias that come after all this stuff. Now dressed in your nightwear, you let out one last stretch, a yawn escaping from your mouth. Getting into your bed sheets, you lay in comfort. Today was a lot, you thought. Another yawn escapes your lips. You must be really tired, you thought, your eyes going half-lidded. And eventually, sleep took over. The moon was high in the sky. The night is quiet, saved for a few late night cars. But this is not enough to wake the sleeping residents. Okay. Dot, dot, dot. Uh-oh. Still broken, huh? You should be careful, Pumpkin.
Oh. Soul? I thought you were supposed to go home. See why I said we should have fixed the window? So, what are you doing here?
Clad in all black with a mask of the same color adorning his face, he slowly makes his way next to the sleeping figure. His reddish eyes bright, filled with adoring love. He reached out and stroked his fingers against his beloved cheek.
Look at my sleeping sweetheart. Makes me wonder who supplies Hugo those sleeping pills.
So Hugo gave him sleeping pills. Okay. All right. So now we're getting somewhere. He probably mentioned to Hugo he couldn't sleep, so he gave him sleeping pills.
He let out a low chuckle as he leaned closer to Voyia. Pulling down his mask, he leaned forward, checking her face before continuing. He buries his face at the dip of her shoulder as he leaves a peck. He takes a deep inhale. He shakes as if he took a whiff of a dangerous and addictive drug.
Look at him. Oh my God, this man is so cute.
I would not, like, if I would have woke up, oh my God, so hi. What are you doing here? No, bad Voyia. One day I will stop.
His eyes bright as he examines every feature of his soulmate's face as he gives Voyia cheek a kiss. I mean, and she didn't wake up? Maybe because I'm a light sleeper. If you kiss my cheek, I'm going to probably wake up.
Frick, you smell so good. Pardon me.
He lifts her arm and watches as it flops down on. Okay.
Deep in sleep, like Sleeping Beauty.
He nibbles her neck, earning him a soft whimper from the sleeping individual. Again, she's not waking up. I need water. I need some water. She hasn't woke up yet.
That is crazy. I would have woken up from him lifting my arm up.
He just chuckled. Quite ticklish, aren't you?
He kept going, his kiss and lapped on his same spot to the point a mark started to form.
Those filthy scum think that they could touch you.
His eyes slanted in anger. His grip on the edge of the bed tightens as he wrinkles the sheets. His breathing heavy.
You're mine. No one else. You belong to me. If I ever see those beasters again, I'll kill them.
Okay, so dial it back a little bit.
Tucking a loose strand away from Voyia's face, he gives her a kiss on the forehead before landing another one on the corner of Voyia's lips. A shiver ran down his spine at the contact. As much as he would like to stay a bit longer, his time is due. He backs away as he covers his face once again with his face mask. He walked towards the ajar window, turning back one last time.
Sorry about the window, pumpkin. I'll make it up to you someday.
He carefully opened the window again. And with that, he's gone.
My goodness. So, Soul is crazy. Thank you for playing day two. Thank you so much for playing The Kid in the Back day two. As of March 11th, 2024, Fantasia, me, not me, but the creator, will be taking a break from developing in hopes of finishing their current internship. Oh, well, I wish you the best of luck, honey. This is so... Your game is awesome, and I'm sure that your fans, and me too, will be waiting for day three and day four and five and whatever else is next. But rest assured, I'll be back to work once I'm free. And I'll be in my Twitter account for the time being that I can't read today. Sorry. Thank you once again, and I hope you enjoyed this update. See you soon. And oh my goodness, this is so sweet. I am so happy I played this. Well, there you guys go. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you so much. Thank you, creator, for making this. This is very, very adorable. I hope to see more from you, and I wish you the bestest of luck on your internship thing.
Peace and love. Stay safe out there, everybody. Bye.